Sir is a member of expert committee of Department of Ayush under the Government of Karnataka. Sir has been awarded for excellence in homeopathy by Homeopathic Society of India. Formerly, sir has worked as an organizing secretary for International Homeopathic Conference held in 2017. Sir has also worked as a consultant in Bangalore Metropolitan Transport Corporation, that is BMTC. He has experience in organizing several national and international homeopathic conference seminars and workshops. Sir has presented several scientific papers in various national and international homeopathic conferences and seminars. He has published several articles in national and international homeopathic journals, as well as conducted many free health camps in urban and rural Karnataka. He has a knowledge of multiple languages and possesses a 30 years of practice in classical homeopathy. We welcome Dr. H.L. Swami, sir, on the screen to present his topic on significance of intercurrent prescription in clinical practice. Over to you, sir. Thank you.
Namaste. So, good afternoon, everybody. Thank you, madam, for the nice words you are talking about me. Before I start today's topic, I extend my warm wishes to all the listeners for today's Akshaya Tritiya, Ramzan, the Eid Milad, and the Basava Jayanti. So, my wishes for all of you. So, good afternoon again. And usually, if you are my student and in the class, usually I used to tell about, before beginning my first class, I used to quote Basavanna, especially his one vachana, which gives the seven characters for a good human being. I always tell these seven characters should be there for any physician, especially homeopathic doctor, it's a must. See, you cannot become a good physician without a good person. Okay? So, Basavanna, whose 888th birth celebration today, so he quotes in one vachana, Kalabeda, Kolabeda, Pusya Nudiyalo Beda, ಮುನಿಯ ಬೇಡ ತನ್ನ ಬನ್ನಿಸಬೇಡ ಇತರ ಹಳಿಯಲು ಬೇಡ ಅಸೂಯ ಪಡಬೇಡ ಇದೇ ಅಂತರಂಗ ಶುದ್ಧಿ ಇದೇ ಬಹಿರಂಗ ಶುದ್ಧಿ ಇದೇ ನಮ್ಮ ಕೂಡಲ ಸಂಗಮನ ಒಲಿಯುವ ಪರ್ಯ ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕಿಲ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಲೈ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫೀಲ್ ಅಕ್ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಎನಿಬಡಿ Don't exaggerate yourself. Okay? Don't get anger. So these are the seven principles he puts forward to be a good person. I know most of our homeopathic doctors, by and large, we follow these things. That's why in the society today, we have a better rapport with our patients compared to our brothers. Generally, we usually will be polite, we speak very simple, usually it will be truthful. So, we'll take an oath that we'll follow this Basavat seven characters and we try to become a better person, better Indians, and better doctors. With this, I start today's lecture. Friends, I think you all heard about the intercurrent remedies or intercurrent prescription. Either you may see in your practice or you may see in your senior's practice the way of using the intercurrent. Just I wanted to know how many of you know, heard, or seen the intercurrent prescription. You can see in my class, usually most of the time I used to take class only after the lunch, post lunch like today. I don't know the strong relationship between 2 to 3 or 3 to 4 and with me. So to avoid the sleep, so it's better to be uninteractive so that I will also know that you are all awake and you are all active listeners. Okay, so either you can put through the chat or you can talk. Just unmute yourself and you can talk. How many of you are aware about the intercurrent remedies or intercurrent prescription? Okay, I'll put in another way. What is intercurrent remedies? Anybody? What is intercurrent remedies or what is intercurrent prescription? Okay. So somebody is putting that intercurrent prescription is a disease preparations. Oh, okay. Dr. Adarsh. Intercurrent prescription are the remedies given during the course of homeopathic treatment for some chronic diseases. Good. When remedy dies due to block. Okay. Then you need to complete the action of constitutional prescription. Good. Mehta. Remedies which are given in between the prescription to remove the miasmatic block. Karuna. Good. Next. Miasmatic blockage. Intercurrent means miasmatic blockage. When case comes to standstill, when medicine prescribed power gets exhausted. Okay, good. Very good. Then remedies are used in intention to help. Aishwarya, yes, you can talk. You can unmute and talk. Made along with constitutional medicine. Aishwarya, raise the hand. No, I should know what exactly you know, which helps complete the action already using the medicine so that you can reach the speedy recovery. Dr. Shubha, good. Dr. Shreya, trigger the action of previous prescription. Oh, good. Okay. So, before we go in detail about the intercurrent prescription, so at least I want to know, next slide, please. When well-selected remedy fails, thought of paucity of symptoms. Good. What are the different types of prescription you know? So intercurrent prescription, may some people know partially, some people, okay, some lot of confusion I'm looking. Okay, in last 9 session, maybe mine is a 10th one. Okay, so I think even I heard few this one. Lot of people are talking about the different types of prescription. It is not I am telling. Your previous speakers also, they talk a lot about the different types of prescription. What are the different types of prescription you understood? Pathological, constitutional, yes. Dr. Aditya, pathological. Somebody else, they put constitutional, good. Then organopathic prescription. Keynote, good, very good. Jishanta. Keynote prescription, yes, already told. State constitutional. Okay, central constitutional will be different from state constitutional, Chaitra. Miasmatic prescription, good. Very good. Based on laboratory investigation, wow, super, okay. In between remedy, I think she is answering for the first question. Pathological prescription, I think already somebody told. Okay. So, straight or specific prescription, acute, chronic, classical, one-sided disease prescription. Okay. One-sided disease prescription. So many new prescription I'm hearing. Good. Okay. Anyhow, so we will see one case and you try to identify a genetic prescription. Okay, good. You try to identify different types of prescription, intuitive prescription. Are Baba, this intuitive prescription is very, very distinct. So in homeopathy, there is no intuitive prescription. It is only intentional prescription. Okay. Sometimes what happens, no, by the way of practice, your experience, suddenly you think, but your mind logically concluded that there is nothing called intuitive prescription. Okay. सपने में मेरा दादा आया, मेरा बाप आया और उसने बोल दिया ये दवा दे दो, वैसा नहीं चलेगा होम्योपैथी में. फर्स्ट प्रिस्क्रिप्शन, सेकंड, वाह कृष्ण कुमारी सुपर, फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड प्रिस्क्रिप्शन, गुड. ओके ओके, सेंसेशन मेथड. सी द मेथड, आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग ऑफ मेथड, आई एम टॉकिंग ऑफ द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्रिस्क्रिप्शन. ओके, सो next slide, we'll see one case, okay, and try to identify the different types of prescription here. This case, the patient name is Mr. PR, around 49 years, from Hyderabad. This case came to me around 10-11 years back. First, the history was brought to me by his brother-in-law, who was working in Bangalore, but patient was in Hyderabad. So his family used to come for my treatment, his brother-in-law family. So he asked, sir, you have any medicine for the fever and infection due to bed sores? Due to bed sores, his brother-in-law used to get oftenly repeated infections and fever. You all know bed sores, which will be a source of an infection and it causes the fever. I told, okay, but I want to know the details. So then he told, patient is paralyzed below the neck. So below the neck, patient doesn't have any sensation. So he cannot have any control. So this is since December 2009. That is almost 1 year before he came to me. Almost 1 year, not exactly. After a spinal surgery, this is a complication after a spinal surgery, to decompress the spine. The patient met an accident 3 months before the surgery. Due to that accident, he had a compression. So to remove this compression, decompress, they did a surgery on the cervical region. Next slide. Patient was a principal in a prestigious school, was known for his the quality of for a good work. He's a very good teacher and a good principal also in the suburb of Hyderabad, who made a good name and fame due to his academic and administrative skills. He was one of the heartthrob of the school institute for the students and the management. One day, while traveling in a passenger auto, I think you all know auto rickshaw, that is three-wheeler, he met an accident and got his head hit to the iron rod on the top of the auto. If at all, if you are traveled in the auto, you all know there will be the iron rods to support the covering of the auto. So while traveling in that auto, they met an accident, and this person got hit to the iron rod, which is above that seat. Okay, next slide. His neck becomes stiff due to concussion. After a detailed investigation, the neurologist suggested the spinal surgery. Okay, they took 2-3 opinions, and the person who came to me, his brother-in-law, he's a very good in post. He is an engineer, and for your information, they are the person who first invented the tab in India. So that person used to work for the BEL in Bangalore. Then he came out and he started his own company. Had a very good distinct contacts. So this person consulted before this thing, 2-3 took the opinions, but everybody told about to this is better to go for a surgery so that the compression, that to decompress the neck. Okay. After the surgery, whole body below the neck got paralyzed. Patient unable to move hands, legs, body below the neck. Even sensations are reduced. Only deep sensations, deep pressure is to make out. So otherwise touch and other things were also reduced. Next. No control over the urine, urination and defecation. You know, all the motor and this thing is lost, so no control. Unable to turn on the bed also. Without the help of an attendee, even he cannot unable to turn. Unable to raise the hand, raise the leg, unable to scratch. Just imagine, you have to visualize this case. Then only you can understand. Hospitalized since then. Since then he is in hospital. So he is in recent blood test just before he consulted me, 1 week before that. So recent blood test shows that his hemoglobin is 8.6, WBC is 18,500, and neutrophils and lymphocytes, I think you can make out 76% and 19%. Platelets are 6.8 lakhs. ESR was 160 mm. What is the normal ESR rate should be? Per hour, 160 mm. What is the normal rate? 18 to 20. For a male or female? 18. For a male or female? You know, ESR differs from for a male and female separate. Up to 20 for female. Right. This is good, Dr. Palak. Jayantirani, very good. Up to 10, 0 to 10 for a male and 0 to 20 for female. Just imagine, is ESR 160 mm per hour. See, the hemoglobins are less, RBC is less, WBC is more, increased. Okay, platelets are more. Okay, next. Here, now tell me, in this position, I have not seen the patient. At that time, I'm talking about 11 years back, there was no Skype, no video call, nothing. Okay, these are the reports he given by his attendant, that is his brother-in-law. And it was a Saturday and Sunday he was supposed to go to Hyderabad. So he came to, if at all any medicine is there to collect, and he can help. So what is your prescription or what is your this thing, thought? How to proceed? How to proceed? In this case, how to proceed? Correct. Clinical or pathological prescription. Fine. So, Mehta, what will be your prescription for this patient? What do you think? Hypericum. Very good. Hypericum. Fine. Good thought. Okay. Hypericum. Good. Okay. Hypericum some JNT 1M. Bell is pair. Super. Okay. Aditya. Bell is Pawan. Bell is very good. Mark. Kya baat? Already you from hypericum you shift to Mark. Staphys agria, pyrogenum, arnica. Wow. Kya baat? Ailment from spinal surgery. Okay. Arnica, Staphys agria. Very good. Calendula. Super. Namrata. Very good. Very good. Calendula. Good. Okay. Then, very good. Agaricus. Pawan, you just elaborate why agaricus? Good. Next. Yogesh, phosphorus. Phosphorus, natrum salts, okay. Maybe as a हेड इंजुरी, अच्छा नेचर ऑफ सॉल्ट, हाँ नेक्स्ट फ्रॉम एनेस्थीसिया इंजुरी टू नर्व काली कार, गुड फास्फरस, गुड प्रगति फास्फरस, देन कास्टिकम राठौर प्रेमा राठौर, ब्लड क्लॉट इन ब्रेन एसिड सेल्फ जयंती रानी, गुड कास्टिकम डॉक्टर निशा, ओके this we'll see what this foolish doctor is given, okay, natrium you Sanjana,
very good,
okay, next slide, I gave pyrogenin 1, okay. So here patient came to me not to decompress. Patient came, did not come to me for this one. He came immediately. Yes, patient has a repeated fever and infection. You got it? Correct. Chaitra, high infection. Okay, correct. Yes, sir. Super. Okay. Next. Just we'll see the follow up. And I given antipyrin. I don't know how many of you heard this drug. Otherwise, go and read Metramedica, Boric or Clark. Okay. I gave Hypericum 1M followed by antipyrin 30. Okay. I don't mix two medicine together. Okay. I may follow it after giving Hypericum next day onwards because patient was in the Hyderabad. I cannot send together. I sent. Okay.
So pyrogenin.
Ah. Yes. Yes, Dr. Trupti.
You said Hypericum, sir. Pyrogenin was given.
No. I never told Hypericum. Pyrogenin 1M and antipyrin. Antipyrin 30. I don't know how many. Why I sent it together is, it is not. First day I given only pyrogenin, followed by antipyrin. Okay. Next. Follow up. So next week he came and he told fever reduced from 103.5 to 100.5. What is it? What you should do now? What you should do? What is your distinct mode now? What is your action? Yes, sir. No, Nancy, correct. Wait and watch. Super, very good. Wait and watch. So I gave the costliest medicine in the world. Okay? Yes, Pragati. Costliest medicine is placebo. Okay. So next one. Fear. Next week, you are so happy, patient. You told no fever, sir. And they are giving the, continuing the physiotherapy. Patient is improving very well. He is taking food. He looks more joyous now. So no fever, no infection. Bed sores are much better. And along with this one, I told to clean the wound with a calendula. Okay. So bed sores are improving very well. It is bed sores are reducing and it's healing. The wound is healing very much. So now patient's attendant become a greedy. Sir, what we can do for the further? Fever, infection is fine, sir. Madam, usually antipyrin repetition, I will give only 3 doses. Okay? So somebody already suggested, now comes the Hypericum stage. Now comes the Hypericum. I gave after the 2 weeks of the medicines, patient general conditions are improving, no fever, no infection. Now I gave the Hypericum. Got it? Any comments? Any doubts in this stage? Repetition of hyperism. No repetition. Why? I just started now. Why I should repeat? Okay, good, clear. So next follow, please. Next slide. Patient is improving except for the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is 7%. Now it become 8.2% in hospital started the steroids for the same, because the hemoglobin is reducing. So when the patient this thing, they started the steroids. See, you have to imagine, this is not under the GHMC hospital. You cannot have your own this thing. So there we have to listen to their administration. So this, what we are giving is only like a, with, you all know, most of the time, patients or patient attendant never tell to the hospital administration about giving the other medicines. Okay. So without their notice, this we used to give. So patient attendant, his brother-in-law came and told me, sir, now because the hemoglobin is less, they started the steroids. Okay. So I prescribed the lecithin. Lecithin 6. How many of you know lecithin? Lecithin. Why I gave lecithin? You're not aware of this drug, lecithin? Anemia. Very good. Very good, Dr. Nandi. For anemia. To improve the hemoglobin, Dr. Bharat. Yes. Yes, hemoglobin is less. So I sent the lecithin 6. Okay. Good. Very good. Very good. Bone marrow cells. Very good, Vishnu. Bone marrow. Very beautiful. So next, after 10 days, the follow-up, hemoglobin level rise to 8.9%. So patient attendants were very happy. The brother-in-law told her sister, that is the sister husband only were treating. Sister is very happy to see the this thing. First time it came to this level. After admitting the hospital, this is the first time patient crossed 8.5%. Okay. So it was almost 9%, 8.9%. So our next follow-up is, I repeated the same thing. Lecithin 6. Good. Next. On 15-10, hemoglobin become 10.5%. And patient can sit for 30 minutes at a stretch. In 85 degree, that was actually, his bed was in such design in such a way it can tilt because of the physiotherapy and other this thing, they made tilting bed. So he was unable to sit for 5-10 minutes before. So after the homeopathic medication, patient could sit at a stretch for almost an half an hour. So that was a big relief, because see, always lying down, so in the same posture, same position, which will cause the infect bed source and other things and source of infection. So it's a big relief for the patients and attendants. So patient could sit at a stretch for 30 minutes now. Okay. So what will be your prescription now? No blood transfusion is given. What will be your prescription? Okay, already shown. It is Placid. Okay. Next follow-up. On November 1st, again, they followed, they came. Pain perception came back. First time, pain perception, which was not missing, came back. Muscles cramp started. Twitching of muscles. Involuntary reflexes, especially twitching of muscles, involuntary reflexes. Somebody asked for the steroids. Yes, steroids was reduced as it was, they will give only like a descending order, ascending order. And yes, when we started, yes, we started lecithin along with steroid, but then it is tapered off. Involuntary muscle reflexes, distension of abdomen, and nausea. So what do you think now? What should be the your next move? I will answer the potency, Dr. Aditya. Don't worry about the potency now. Just observe what are the different prescription we are giving. So what physician should do at this time? Next slide. So I sent the placebo. So you may be asking why, even though there was so much of twitching of muscles, cramped muscles were there, distance of abdomen, all these things, why you are not giving? These are all a good sign. These are all good sign. Reflexes are, nerves are coming, this thing. It's a good sign for a homeopath. Okay? Very good. Case taking in detail and give the constitutional medicine. Good. So, and further follow up when the patient came. So, involuntary other things are now reduced except for the reflexes. Twitching of muscles and reflexes are high. Aditya, I told you I will tell about the potency, not now. Don't discuss now. Okay? Okay. Potency we will discuss in the last. So, on 20th November, reflexes are high. So, what do you think? Good. Next slide. I gave sulfur CM. Okay, next slide. The involuntary reflexes had increased for 5 days, then it reduced, fever came back, pain perception improved, sensation for touch came back. This is a very drastic, remarkable change. The sensation for touch came back. Healing of wound is much better. Okay? Next slide. That was on January 8th. So patient was improving except for constipation. Neurological and muscular improvement is very good. Neurologist who are seeing this patient was very happy with the progress and asked the people, what is the change? Why we are getting so much of improvement now? What any changes this thing? Then the relatives discussed about the homeopathic medicine they are giving and was so happy and we told continue the homeopathic medication. Okay, next. So patient can lift his hand, can stand in a frame for 1 hour. Imagine. Who was unable to sit for 5 minutes, now we can stand for 1 hour. Can sit in wheelchair, can support his neck, can feel the bladder when it is full. Okay? See here, what is the remedy? What do you think now? What we should give? See, here already 3 months we waited. More than three, four months. Our previous prescription. It is be almost April. Okay. Good. So next, show the next this thing, the remedy. Casticum 200. Next slide. On the May 5th, patients can feel the urge now. So they remove the catheter. They remove the catheter first time after the surgery. Okay. So this is the case. Almost we continue from the 2010 August. From 2011 May, the patient was under our supervision. In between, I went, they took me to Hyderabad. I went and saw the patient and came back. First time I went and see the patient, okay? So after that, patient was improving. And even the brother-in-law was there in Bangalore, they relocated to Hyderabad. So his contact was less, okay? But they were updating me about the progress. Patient was improving very well. And even, I think after another 4 or 5 months, even the discharge was taking this thing, continuing the physiotherapy from the house, okay? Now you tell me how many types of prescriptions you saw. How many prescriptions you saw? Three. Okay. Three. Four. Good. Four. Okay. Can you name what are the different types of prescription we used here? Pathological, good. Then constitutional intercurrent, very good. Nidhi, beautiful. State, I don't know what is the state. Causative, okay, causative. Pathological, constitutional intercurrent, good. Good. Very good. Total five treatment, good. Very good. Good observations, okay. Huh. So first we gave the first medicine based on the laboratory investigations. Second one, first one we based on the etiology, second one laboratory investigation, and third one on the causative factor, fourth one as an intercurrent, fifth one or the final one. After I visited the patient in the Hyderabad, then we gave his constitutional medicine. Totally five prescriptions you could see in one case. Don't think that all the cases in one remedy, one dose will cure. That is our ideal cure. That is good, but don't expect it. Don't expect, don't get confused. This case I showed to show that it is not that you will be inferior if you use more than one drug in the case, nothing. For us, the patient and how the patient improves, that is more important than what this one. You have to change the remedies. You have to prescribe the medicine according to the situation, according to the case. It is not that all the cases will cure with one dose. Even I have a lot of cases where I given one dose and waited for 6 months. That is also there. And we completed so many cases with one dose. That is the ideal one. But you cannot expect the ideal cases in every case. Okay? See, you should be an unprejudiced observer. then only you can help the patient in better. Okay, good. I think this one case opened up so many this thing and a lot of questions to be answered. I know I will keep that at the end. So now next slide, in brief, I'll show what are the different types of prescription: acute prescription, etiological prescription, chronic one, constitutional, family history based, Keynote, intercurrent, miasmatic, nosological, organopathic, palliative, past history based, pathological, preventive, synthetic, and tautopathic. Most of this one are self-explanatory. You know all these things. These are the words are not new to me, new to you. Okay. So, which is the intercurrent? See, any prescription can become intercurrent. Out of this 16 one, except the seventh, all prescription can become intercurrent prescription. It based on the case and the stage. Okay? Any prescription will become intercurrent prescription. Okay? Any doubt in this stage? Any doubt? Or we'll go further? Okay. Intercurrent prescriptions. Today's topic, what is intercurrent prescription? Why, when, and how? Whenever the question comes about the intercurrent prescription, these are the four fundamental questions will come. What, why, when, and how? Okay, next. So intercurrent prescription, the meaning of intercurrent is running between. The dictionary meaning of intercurrent is running between or intervening. Intervening. If you go to the actual dictionary and see, it is an intervening. The medicine of a disease or a condition, simultaneous. If it occurs simultaneous, either it may be a disease or it's a medicine, simultaneously occurring at the same time or during the same period, another condition or another remedy is called the intercurrent. This is the dictionary meaning, okay? Most of the time, the type of prescription, intercurrent prescription, where the pathology is given more important than the personality. Pathology is given more importance than the personality, okay? Why we prescribe intercurrent remedies? To remove the miasmatic block, one. Second, to stop the recurrence of the problem and to complete the cure, okay? Next, when we'll give intercurrent prescriptions are the remedies given during the course of homeopathic treatment for some chronic disease for the purpose of removing any acute disease or acceleration, the mode of cure, or remove any hindrance called miasmatic blocks. For all this time we use, one is when there is a chronic disease is there, at that time some acute exacerbation comes or acute disease comes, then we will give it to accelerate the cure rate, then we will use it to remove the hindrance, miasmatic block, we'll use it. Okay? So, disease occurring during the progress of other disease, then we have to use the intercurrent. When the disease occurring during the progress of another disease. Okay, next slide, no problem. We must, how to use it? So, there is no better word than the Kent, what he writes in Lesser Writing. So most of you may be thinking, Kent is a pure constitutional prescriber, but I will tell you, he is the best observer and modern student of the Hahnemann and homeopathy. He was very open, okay? We must rise above the miasmatic prescribing, yet miasm should be held in a view. It is not only miasm, but miasm should be in the view and the remedy should be held in a view. There should be remedy also, there should be miasm also. And the remedy that fits the symptom should also be deep enough to cure the corresponding miasm. So Kent says the prescription, the chronic, especially chronic intercurrent prescription, should rise the above miasmatic prescription, but miasm should be covered. Remedy should be deep enough to take care of the cure the corresponding miasm, but it should match the patient. Remedy should match the patient. Just you cannot give it. So it is a syphilitic miasm is the, this thing is a, just give syphilinum or sorenum. It's not like that one. It also has to match the case. Okay. Who introduced this intercurrent remedies? Dr. Hahnemann introduced this word. Intercurrent remedies was first introduced to homeopathy by Hahnemann in 1828, the first edition of Theory of Chronic Diseases. He describes the method of using acute and intercurrent remedies. Clear? Okay, we'll see how the views of Hahnemann. According to Hahnemann, the intercurrent remedies used when a well-indicated remedy fails to give a desired results. Okay, when well-indicated medicine fails to give a desired result, then you can use this. It is usually prescribed where the indicated remedy works well for a while and begins to taper off. Can be in the form of a no-sold, it can be in the form of a complementary, or it can be in the form of a constitutional, it may be a polycrest. Okay? So Hahnemann says this, when the indicated remedy works and then it slows down, it tapers off, it stops further contributing, then you can use the intercurrent, maybe in the form of a no-sold or a polycrest remedy or a complementary or constitutional. Okay? This is for a chronic. For acute, next. Acute intercurrent remedies are used during the temporary disruption of the chronic treatment. When the chronic treatment is going on, if there is a temporary disruptions, then you can think of acute intercurrent. You can see in the page number 221 of the chronic disease. Okay, next. So what are the acute intercurrents? Acute intercurrents are those remedies given during the acute crisis in the management of a chronic disease. When you are managing a chronic disease, if there is an acute crisis comes, for example, you are treating a case of psoriasis, or in the case of rheumatoid arthritis, or a case of the migraine, any chronic disease, you are treating with the constitutional prescription, suddenly COVID came. The patient become COVID positive, or he started giving the symptoms of COVID. You are giving the medicine according to the presentation of this acute crisis. That is acute intercurrent. You got it? That is acute intercurrent. You took the case, you asked for the symptoms, causation, aggravation, modalities, all that you take care, and you give the medicine which is covering this acute phase, that is an acute intercurrent. This acute crisis may be due to any cause. It may be the weather change, getting wet, trauma, both mental and physical traumas. For example, when you are treating a case, suddenly the near and dear may, the patient may lose the near and dear person, maybe a parent, maybe a spouse. That is a trauma. At that time, you have to give, to come out of that trauma, you have to give the acute, the intercurrent. It may be an injury. It may be acute miasm, some epidemics like COVID. Can any exciting factor may cause the acute crisis, but it is different from the clinical picture of a chronic natural disease. Very, very, very few cases where the constitutional remedy itself will reflect. That time, you just repeat one more dose of constitutional remedy, that will take care. But those chances are very less. Most of, if at all, if there is a different picture, clinical picture came at that time, you have to prescribe a different acute remedy. Okay? So According to Hahnemann in the chronic diseases, he writes the example, arsenic, taking cold in the stomach by eating fruit. After eating fruit, take the cold, this thing, he prescribes arsenic, okay? These remedies, acute intercurrents, which is chosen by exciting cause and acute active symptoms so that they do not disturb the deeper layer associated with the fundamental cause and constitution. When you are selecting the acute intercurrents, you are taking the exciting cause or the active symptoms. It may be a sensation, it may be a location, it may be a modalities, positive modality, aggravation, remuneration, if at all any concomitants are there, that you are taking as a that totality. So that you are prescribing on that totality, where it may not deeper disturb the deeper layer associated with the fundamental cause. Fundamental cause may be different, constitution may be different, but when there is acute crisis, you take that acute, this totality and prescribe. They are crafted to be a superficial on purpose, so they do not interfere with the complementary constitutional treatment. When you are selecting, it is crafted to a superficial purpose and it will not interfere with the complementary or a constitutional treatment. Okay, I'll give one case to understand. Okay, go back. Okay. Here, this case actually came from GHMC only, one of the my students in GHMC. She completed her BHMS, maybe joined MD or may not be before joining MD. She was working with a very popular homeopathic doctor of this place. Suddenly, one night, she called me and she told, sir, I'm admitted in the hospital for acute abdomen. Severe pain in the abdomen. And neither I can say it, stand, walk, sleep, change this thing. So severe pain associated with the severe nausea, vomiting. I am unable to eat. I am unable to drink anything. So his brother was a surgeon, immediately admitted in the hospital. So then they were planning for a surgery under 2-3 days. So she called, sir, can we, homeopathy can help in this stage, can we avoid? Okay. See, homeopathy helps in emergency, acute abdomen. What are the different causes for acute abdomen? Yes, good, yes. What are the different causes you can think acute abdomen? Surgery, third year. Appendicitis, very good, appendicitis, beautiful, okay. Next, don't write the same thing. Appendicitis, okay, next. Cholecystitis, beautiful, okay. Cholecystitis, next. Pancreatitis, good. Then, intestinal obstruction, good. Very good, diverticulitis. IBS will not be that severe. Renal colic, yes. Renal colic. Next. Ovarian, very good. Who is this? Dr. Sangeeta, very good. Intersusception, beautiful. Yes. Torsion, yes. Good. Fatty liver, I never seen fatty liver in that emergency cases. I don't know. Intestinal, somebody already put intersusception. Ischemia, okay. Intestinal ischemia, acute peptic ulcer, beautiful. Acute peptic ulcer, gastric ulcer, good. Alcoholic liver abscess, okay. Liver abscess itself, okay. Especially ruptured liver abscess. Intestinal perforation, very good. Ulcerative colitis, yes, sometimes. Not IBS, ulcerative colitis, yes, I can take. Cyst, very good. Which cyst? Mesenteric lymphadenitis not will cause of so severe acute abdomen. Okay, beautiful. You wonderful. You are all PCOD, not so much. Okay. You are all very good in the diagnosis part. So your OBG teachers is so beautiful. You are good. And you are even surgery teachers, not OBG, sorry, surgery teachers. Hernia itself is not an acute abdomen, this thing. Okay. Good. So here, in this case, so prolapse. Okay. So next slide. This patient actually had the acute pancreatitis and cholecystitis, acute on chronic cholecystitis. The calculi lodged in CBD, distal part of the CBD. So what is CBD? Common bile duct. Okay. The small calculi measuring of 2 to 3 mm. You can see I underlined there. Okay. If you want, you can just enlarge it and you can see. Okay. No, go back. Back, please. Good. So, correct. Same. Okay. So you see here the sonographic date is very important. This sonography is taken on the 4th December. And she called on the night. So I told, okay, you send some attendants, I'll send the medicine, we'll see. And she told, sir, it is, surgery is posted on 7th. She called on 4th night. She told surgery is posted on 7th. So 4th means 4th night is over now. I mean, it was almost, I was closing my clinic this thing. So I told the next day, it is 5th. Only 2 days left for me. Can you think we can avoid the surgery? What do you think? Okay, show the next slide. See this slide. See the sonography. What is the impression? Normal size of the pancreas. History of acute pancreatitis was there. Presently, it was normal size of the pancreas with a mild alterated structure. No obvious necrosis or peripancreatic fluid. And no calculi in the CBD. You can see CBD. You go up. See there. No calculi is seen. At present, no calculi is seen. Mild ascites. Okay. Past of the calculus. Prominent CBD was there, but no calculus in the CBD present scan, cause of the calculi. Now you see the date. It was 6th December, just 24 hours. 5th, they collected the medicine, 5th afternoon. Actually, they were supposed to do this scan on 7th morning before surgery because the sonographist was not available on the that day, Saturday. So they did the sonography on the previous day. Actually, the patient was a little anxious. She called me and asked, sir, they are asking for the scan, to take the scan now. What will do? Because tomorrow they are not available. So otherwise, I have to go straight away to the surgery. I told, no, you go for this scan. See this one. Symptomatically, patient was relieved by the afternoon itself. she started taking the liquids orally. But scan 24 hours, just in the scan to scan date 2 days, but this thing within 24 hours. And next day, when the patient was supposed to post for the surgery, surgeon told it is not. Is the homeopathy slow? This is the cases where this patient is already was on the treatment for the poliolithiasis, where she was working with a senior. That person, the doctor was giving for last 3 months treatment, but she was not knowing what medicine was given. Okay, but this came acute exacerbation of the chronic disease. And you have to play with a right acute intercurrent so that you can get the result like this. Okay? Okay, fine. So next slide. Chronic intercurrents. So what are the chronic means? Hahnemann says about chronic intercurrents. Chronic intercurrents are those medicine which are usually given anti-miasmatic remedies in the midst of chronic treatment of miasmatic blocks. Okay, whereas acute crisis, whereas in the chronic intercurrents are used to remove the miasmatic blocks. Okay, and suppressions and obstacle to cure. So chronics are used to remove the miasmatic block, remove the obstacles to the cure. Okay, remove the suppression. The remedy was not mentioned, yes. Okay, so this actually I wanted to show as a the efficacy of an intercurrent, acute intercurrent. That's why I did not put, because it will again open up the ponder box. Why that remedy? Why in this potency? So that's why I did not put it. I given sulfur CM. The prescription was sulfur CM. Why I gave, you read your books. Okay, if I tell it is only one line, if you read, you will understand much better. Okay, good. Next slide. Many modern constitutionalists do not believe in acute remedies and say they are all suppressive. This is a big thing. A lot of my students, my fellow practitioners, my juniors are, sir, I am interested to practice homeopathy, sir, but I'm afraid if I give some medicine and it becomes suppressed, I suppress the case. First, remove this bhuta, suppress bhuta, okay? By giving a dynamic dose of one dose of medicines, you are not suppressing any case. So wherever it is required, use the acute remedies. It is required, it's a part. Each one has its own role. The main purpose of taking this topic today is to make sure that you will understand the homeopathic efficacies apart from a constitutional distinct. Okay? Modern homeopaths no longer understand how to use the acute intercurrent remedies. Let us know what our master, great master Kent says about the intercurrent remedies. Otherwise, you are all, they're all followers of Kent. They use only one remedy, only constitutional, no acute, no intercurrent, okay? And here I'm telling only what Kent says, Kent view on the intercurrent remedies. It is important to avoid getting confused by two disease images. Listen carefully, read between the lines. It's very important to avoid getting confused by the two disease images that may exist in the body at the same time. This is what Kent says, okay? Avoid getting confused when there are two images are present in the same body. Next, a chronic patient, for instance, may be suffering from an acute disease. Chronic patient like a migraine, like a psoriasis, may suffer from an acute disease and the physician on being called may think that it is necessary to take the totality of the symptom. Not every time. See, you remember the case, first case, when the patient came and told about the bed sores, infection and fever. I was not worried about the taking totality of the symptom, constitution and all that one. I just, to understand the patient, I took all the details. Okay, you should be very clear to see the images. Next. But if he should do that in an acute disease, if at all a physician do mix that, take the totality, mixing the both chronic and acute symptoms together, he will become confused and will not find the right remedy. This is very, very important underline. If you mix both chronic and acute symptoms, symptomatology together, then you will become more confused. You will not find a right remedy. Next slide. Group of symptoms that constitute the image and appearance of an acute miasm must be prescribed for. When there is an acute distinct, you have to prescribe on the group of symptoms that constitute the image, acute image. Okay? Acute miasm. You have to prescribe on that. The chronic symptom will not, of course, will not be present when the acute miasm is running, because the latter suppresses or suspends the chronic symptoms. But a diligent physician, not knowing this, he so might wrongly gather together all the symptoms that the patient has in their lifetime. A diligent physician, out of this thing, or this one, he may not take on all the symptoms together that patient has in his whole lifetime. Okay, next. He correctly reminds homeopaths that when a strong crisis mistunes the vital force, it suspends the chronic symptoms. Kent correctly reminds us, when the strong crisis mistunes the vital force, it suspends the chronic symptoms while acute diseases run its course. Next, if you give a remedy by the chronic symptom during acute crisis, it runs the risk of serious disruptions of the nature of the symptom pattern. If you give a chronic remedy on the chronic symptom during acute crisis, you have made disruption the nature of symptom pattern and you will get more confused. Many of our modern constitutional homeopaths are much like the diligent physician of whom Kent was speaking. You got it? Okay, next. They mix all the symptoms of acute diseases, chronic miasm, and innate constitution all together without even realizing it, as they pay little attention to the layers. Always search for one remedy that covers everything at once. You got it? We all do it, no? At least in the beginning, we'll confuse and you do it. We'll put everything together. We take around 30, 40 symptoms for the repertorization and try to work out and get one remedy. This can be a great mistake in a strong exacerbation of a chronic diseases or in acute shock or a trauma or physical injuries or during the virulent acute miasm like a COVID now, virulent acute miasm. Okay, at that time, if you are taking all these things, it's a great mistake you are doing. The proper treatment for a true crisis is an acute intercurrent remedy. At that time, what is the right to this thing? Proper treatment, right treatment is to identify a true crisis of an acute intercurrent remedy and prescribe that. Okay, 1 minute. So I think you realize what is the intercurrent remedy, what are the types, when it is used, and how to use it. Hope you could understand this. This is very, very important. Organon, sometimes it may look boring, but organon, as per my this thing, always I tell organon should be taught on the bedside. That's why I started with the case. Okay, only when you teach the organon on bedside, it will be, you can understand it better. Okay? So, Dr. Bharat, how much time I have? I brought few cases. Can I discuss?
Yes, sir. You can continue, sir. We have 40 minutes.
Okay, good. Okay, then we'll see some cases so we will understand the different types of the intercurrents I used both in acute and chronic. Okay? Okay. We'll see this case. The baby named CR, the child aged about 2 years, brought to my clinic on August 2019 by her parents for delayed speech. Actually, this patient went to different pathies, neurologists, psychologists, psychiatrists, even homeopaths, very popular homeopath. They are from Baseshnagar, I think nearby some Vijayanagar or somewhere near, very popular one with the doctors of the show. Then one of the her father's colleague was taking treatment for this child for almost similar complaints. So with that reference, this child came to me on 21st August 2019. Okay. So main thing is, patient was not speaking. It was only sighing. If they want milk, they show like sighing. Want to eat, drink, or you want that, this only hand sign. Okay. Patient was not speaking even at the age 2+. Okay. She is sensitive to sound. Patient used to startle when bells ring from nearby temple. So even though she knows every day that bell rings, but suddenly she startles, then she smiles. Okay. Fear of alone always clings to the mother. And one more observation the parents noticed is the patient walks on the toes. Okay. So this is the present complaint. So now we'll go to the life space situation. She was adopted child. Adopted when child was around four and a half months old from a Dharwad adoption center. And this child was, they told it's a premature child. It was abandoned on the road immediately after the birth. No neonatal care. Child cried non-stop for days. So before it adoption center and this one, child used to cry non-stop. When she started crying, it used to not stop for days together. This was the information the patient could give to me, only this information, because they don't know the biological parents' history, family history, and other things. What are the information they could collect from the adoption center? Only this much they could tell about the past history and the family history. Only this much we know. Okay. Next, generals. Physical generals, appetite varies, very moody. Sometimes she eats well, sometimes doesn't eat at all. Bowels, constipation, towards constipated, and especially the colicky pain at night since the infancy. Okay, since the child was brought to their house, patient used to cry, make this thing colic, and they used to give the medicine to release that colic. Okay, desire. Was very choosy. There is no particular desire. She sometimes like what she likes today. Next day, she may not like the same food. Okay. The sleep, erratic, weeps on sleep, grinds her teeth during the sleep. The patient used to grind her teeth during the sleep. Next. Mental symptoms. Hyperactive child. Very hyperactive. Even in my clinic, literally, her mother used to hold their hands and legs by locking from hand her mother's hand and this thing. The moment, 1 second, then the child used to make whole my clinic mess. Very hyperactive child, but very fast learner. She used to learn very fast. She used to pick up. Happy and cheerful child. Likes to bite the things. Likes to bite the people. She used to bite the plastic or some this thing, cloth. Sometimes she bites the people, especially the servant who, the Aya, who used to take care of her or the mother. Sensitive to cloth, does not wear a single cloth, especially during the summer, the patient doesn't like to wear a single cloth, sucks the fingers, not only thumb, all the fingers, she used to suck two, three fingers together, likes music, dance. So this is the history. So this is the history we could collect. So what do you think? Which is, how to go ahead? How do you proceed? Tarantula, very good. Sunil, good. Tarantula, why tarantula? Because hyperactive. Opium, oh sure, because constipation. Tuberculum, very good. Dr. Palak, tuberculum, okay. At least tubercular miasm is very strongly running. Apis, bismuth. Bismuth, why bismuth? Pawan, tuberculum, yes, somebody already put tuberculum. Hyoscyamus, very good, very good. Okay. Anything? Sir, the acute intercurrent remedy potency must be low. Silica, oh, super, Dr. Palak, okay, super, good. I did not see that one. I'll just see, read some acute intercurrent something that came. Natrium, silica, calcarea car, medorinum. Sir, for acute intercurrent remedy potency must be low or what? And for superficial action, what is the thing? Okay. See, Chaitra, you see in my case, even in acute intercurrent remedy, I given the CM also. It need not be low. Again, the potency selection should be based on the reactive power of a person, the substance or the source of the medicine, the pathology, virulence, miasm, all these things will decide the potency. Okay? Just, it is like, even intercurrent is like any other this thing, any other prescription. It is based on individual. Okay? Good. Dr. Trupti, show the prescription. Prescription was carcinosin 1. Okay, show the follow. The first follow up next time they came. Mother was so surprised. She was so pleasant. She was telling, sir, child started speaking more than 3-4 words at a time. Now ask for the things instead of action. Become cheerful. Sorry. Tantrum reduced by 30-40%. Clarity is better both in speech and action. No change in quantity, the quality of sleep, sorry, quantity, number of hours of sleep, but quality of sleep is better. First 2 days, she used to wake up and cry. But now, after giving the medicine, first 2 days she is to wake up and cry, but now it is reduced. So, our next follow-up was fear. Next, improving, especially speech and hyperactivity, reduced, speech is improved, constipation, reduced but still there, 1+. Sleep less in the afternoon, but little better in the night, but still it is less. Irritable, 2+. wants to remove the clots, especially before or during the full moon time, even during the new moon time. Okay? Even now, patient wants to remove the clots, but especially during the or before or during the full moon or new moon. So now what is the remedy? Why carcinosis? Okay. Chamomilla. Okay. Sir, can you show the repertory chart on this case? Alumina. Okay. Silica. Good. Calcarea. Wonderful. Okay. Any other remedies? Just think. Think. Okay. Iosimus. Iosimus, calcarea carb, very good. Calcarea silica, good. Very good. Very interactive. Good crowd. Good crowd. Very good. Yes, Dr. Drupti, show the remedy. Yes, as most of you rightly identified the remedy, it is the silica. Silica is her constitution. Silica is her constitution. Okay. Now, okay, we'll discuss the remedy, or we'll say, just see the follow up and then discuss the remedy. Just we'll finish the follow up. On 9-11, improving, she started reciting the rhymes, did not utter a single word in a school interview. So parents were happy that she started talking this thing and rhymes and all. So they are very confident. So they took the school for school interview. There she did not even utter a single word. Answered all the questions after coming back from the school. What all they asked, she answered everything, but not in front of the in school interview committee. Constipation reduced, sleep little better, irritability reduced. Little mood swings on the 11th day of waning moon and new moon day. Okay, so this is our follow up. So now, yes, let us know. Before that, we'll discuss this case. So, any doubt about why I gave silica, or doubt is on with the carcinosis? So, silica, you all know. Walking on the toes and all that one. So somebody asked for repertory sheets. Usually in my from the system to repertory sheets is not so easy. So my laptop is little older one. And otherwise I would have showed. Even on repertorization, silica was the remedy. And as majority of you rightly identified, good. But when the case came to me, I thought, yes, even the full moon and new moon is also silica. So this new moon phases is very important, especially this type of cases. First of all, I'll tell you, this is a case of autism. I don't know how many of you identified it or not. It's an autistic child. Because of that only, the parents went to so many this thing, therapist, treatment, all that one, without much of this thing. And when the patient came to me, was shown to more than 10 doctors. Okay? So, I have to make the platform right. Autosomal. So, for that, for to work the indicated remedy, you have to make the first this correct corrections. That's why I started with a chronic intercurrent remedy, carcinosin. Carcinosin, I think majority of us in our clinical practice miss the picture because it mimics like silica, it mimics like phosphorus, it mimics like natramune, it mimics like tuberculum. Okay, carcinos picture is always give the picture of different one. But especially tuberculum and carcinosins are almost goes hand in hand when you see the patient or when you see the picture. But one strong indication for the carcinosin is insomnia in the children. Even if you go through the Fobister is one of the author who gave the best picture of carcinosin. Okay, there's a small booklet around 40, 50 pages booklet is there. I think it's available even in the online also or bookstores. Please purchase and read carcinosin. Okay, whenever the carcinosin by Fobister. Whenever there's a picture where the clarity of a single remedy is not there, it's overlapping, think of carcinosin. Whenever there is a past or family history of multiple diseases, think of carcinosin, especially the tuberculosis, rabies, pernicious anemia. In this case, it was not there, no family history. But these are also an indication for a carcinosin. Okay. Clear now? We'll go to next case. Bharat?
Yes, sir. Yes.
We'll go to next case. Fine. I think we'll discuss this or maximum one more case. Okay. And we'll go for a question answer session. This case, the lady, aged around 62 years, well-built, dark in color, elderly woman, visited my clinic on February 2nd for following complaint. Pain in left shoulder with the stiffness of the left side of the neck, especially when she take her left hand backside and lay, that time it pains, when she takes her left hand back or when laying on the left side. For last 3-4 months, this is the main complaint. Apart from that, when I asked any other thing, she told about there is an itching in the body since last 2 years, more especially in the daytime, burning in the mouth for last 6 months, unable to sit down on the floor since last 10 years, okay? Excessive hair falling since 2 weeks. Next, dark discoloration on the both hands. Patient basically chilly. So as usual, nobody directly comes to us. After all pathy, after all hospitals, only they come to us. Primarily they went to the orthopedic doctor. He ordered for the MRI. MRI report came. His primary abnormality appeared to be thickening of coracochondral ligament within the rotator cuff interval. Okay. There is a ligament, thickening of the ligament in the rotatory cuff. Possibility of mild thickening of the superior glenohumeral ligament as well. Mild to moderate subacromial subdeltoid bursitis. Small joint effusion with tendinopathy of the subscapularis. These are the reports of the MRI. Okay. So with this patient came, how do you start? What is your prescription? Thickening of the ligament? Bursitis, severe pain in the left, unable to take even her, what you call it? Hair, unable to make her own hair. Actually, these are all elderly people. Children are got married and went of this thing. So husband doesn't know how to make the hair and she could not do it because she is unable to take her hand back. What is the remedy? See, here we took case for more than 40-50 minutes. What are I am giving is only the gist or the important points. Okay? Any remedies? Bryonia, very good. Mastox, fine. Good. Pyramid. Pyramid. Okay. Right or left? Pyramid. Calcarea floor. Spigelia. Achha, because I told now left, it is spigelia. Okay. Next. Tuja. Good. Arnica. Very good. Arnica. Next. Causticum. Super. Next. Belladonna, very good. Symphytum, why symphytum? No fracture, okay. Calmia, very good, calmia. Syphilinum, because night aggravation. Sanguinaria, even for left side, good. Lactic acid, very good. Hydrogenium. Lycopersicum, wow, agaricus, good, deep tea, very good. Then, Bellisper, Ruta, super, Sushankar Mudgal, Colocynth, Dr. Deep tea, good, good. Ruta, okay, good. Sulfur, Chaitana, wow, super. Okay, Tripti, Actia racemosa, okay. Ammonium car, good. I think Dr. Swami is always known to give something which you are not taught, okay? Paris quadralis. Anybody heard this one? Remedy? Paris quadralis? Used? Wonderful medicine, I will tell you, go and read, especially the beautiful medicine for spondylitic types of pains. Yes, Vishwanath, best for spondylitis, exactly. Spondylitis and spondylosis for both, Vishwanath. Spondylosis also. Okay? So they follow up. And next week, she came, she told, pain is a little better, but numbness still persists, numbness on the both hands. So as a placebo, some biochemic, this thing. So I gave biochemic Kali fast, it acts on the nerves, but very purpose of giving is like a placebo. Next, burning in the mouth reduced 60%, dryness of skin reduced, pain little better, stiffness of the left shoulder 1+. It was reduced, but it's still there. On 13th March, I prescribed the intercurrent remedy. Now you see this changes. After 2 weeks, both pain and stiffness is 25% better. Straight away. Okay. Next. 50% better. No medicine is given in between. 50% better. Next. Pain and stiffness more than 75% better. Skin rashes 80%, but marks are present. Burning in mouth 50% better. Weakness 30% better. Again, our best the medicine, second best medicine is given. And next follow-up, no pain while moving her hand backwards. She can move now. She can go back. She can make her ear herself. That was a big relief for her. Okay? You know, ladies, how much importance they give for these things. Okay, now tell me, what is that 20 current remedy which changes so much? Okay, if you are not getting, you will learn one more case which the same intercurrent I given, so that then at least you can think. Okay, we'll see the next case which got the same intercurrent remedy. Patient name is DR. She was around 46 years old, fair, lean, tall, middle-aged woman, walked into my clinic on January 31st with the following complaints. Pain in both knees since 2-3 months. First started in the left knee, now it is on the right. Unable to bend her knees, unable to sit. Menses are irregular since 1.5 years, being she is nearing to the her menopause age. X-ray of both knees showed OA changes in both knees. So she went to, as usual, she went to orthopedic. They took the X-ray and they told, sent the report. The OA means osteoarthritic changes in both the knees. She talked about 1 hour. Just imagine, she talked about, generally we do a lot of time to speak. Even I got exhausted. How she maintained her health, the regime, her yoga, exercise, walk, maintaining good habits, about her meditation, all these things. She is a fitness freak, walking daily twice for 40 minutes, doing yoga daily, taking stairs instead of lift, walking to buy the vegetables on instead of the two-wheeler, she walks. She came with her 20 years old daughter. She was looking more fitter than her daughter. Okay, what is your prescription? Remedy? Yes. What is the remedy? Colocin. Lachesis. Colocin. Good. Next. Sepia. Very good. Please do sepia. And Rihan. Phosphorus. Very good. Because linking. Kali Bhai, Dr. Sangeeta. Naxomica, Dr. Pawan. Okay, good. Kali Iodate, very good. Nandini Reddy, arsenic. Okay. It's not taking much time. We'll go to this thing. Chloric acid. As somebody told rightly, yes, Dr. Shivshankar Mudugan, even I also gave the lachesis. Where it was very clear, very loquacious, pains were moving front, right to left, fitness freak, all that one. Okay? Heart patient, all that was a exact fit lachesis. Okay, lachesis 200. Next, follow up. No perceptible changes. Yeah, doctor, yeah, nimbake ashtu kelkom bande. Lot of people recommended, but there is no result, no change. So follow up, even in follow up, she talked for more than 15 to 20 minutes. Okay, next. Again, after a month, no change. After 2 months, then I gave a intercurrent. Now you see the results. Within a week, 50% better. No pain except in the left knee while ascending and flexing, except while the climbing stair and flexing, no pain, even in the knees. So next, our next costless medicine. Okay, next follow-up. Within a month after giving the intercurrent, 90% better. Next month, we waited for one more month. No complaints. She can do all yoga asanas, including Padmasana. I don't know how many of you know Padmasana. So it is not so easy, unless otherwise your knees will be fit. we stop the treatment. Now, tell me, what was the remedy? No, before that, one, go back. What was the remedy? What was our intercurrent remedy? In last two cases, sulfur. Very good, sulfur. Tuberculum. Why tuberculum, madam? Meda. Dhirendra. See. Medorinum. Okay. Sulfur, medorinum, tuberculum. Next. Tuja. Okay. Next. Tuja. Diti. Calendula. Medorinum. The remedy given was O-A-N. Anybody knows this remedy? O-A-N-1-N. Yes. Osteoarthritic nosoda. O-A-N-1-N was the prescription. Okay? So next slide. Any questions? Now you ask the questions. I think I have another 10 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes. Is it Bharat? I can take another 10, 15 minutes now? Dr. Bharat.
Yes, sir.
If there is no question, thank you. Thank you very much. Name of the last one minute. I will just go to. What is the thing that should be taken care so that it would not disturb the consciousness? See. When there is an indicated medicine, it will not disturb your constitutional medicine at all. Most of the intercurrent remedies will either finish with its action and it complements your constitutional medicine, except during the acute intercurrents, acute crisis. After the acute crisis, intercurrent remedy, you may have to repeat your constitutional prescription after the end of acute crisis. But most of the chronic intercurrents may not be required to repeat even constitutional medicine. On the other end, it will extend the benefits of the It will extend the benefit of your constitutional medicine. It may work as a complementary also. Okay? What are the overlapping? Overlapping symptoms of the remedies you are to give carcinosin autism. See, I'm not telling overlapping remedies are symptoms. I'm telling indication of selecting the carcinosin whenever there is no clear picture of a single remedy. If you think that 2-3 remedies are almost coming equal. See, sometimes when you see the patient, when you see the take the case, there will be a picture of 2-3 remedies in the beginning. But as the case advances, as the case you took, and the clarity will come, then usually very small group will be remaining. And with the going back to your repertory, then you will get the picture clarity of one drug. But here, what happens, however this thing you do it, you may not get it, because the carcinosin, one of the indication for the to select the carcin according to Fobister is there was multiple pictures. Sir, as in the last case where Lachesis 200 was given, how many doses required before intercurrent was prescribed? See, usually I told you all my cases, so I give called as a split dosage, that I usually I'll give 3 doses with 4-hour interval. For example, Lachesis 200 means Lachesis 200 morning, afternoon, night with 4 hours interval I'll give. That's how. For me, it is a single dose, but it's a split dose. Okay, majority of the cases, unless otherwise, if they're giving for either biochemical or a physiological active medicine like lecithin we give, only this type of medicines only I may repeat once a day. Otherwise, generally, I don't repeat any drug. Usually, my way of prescription is one day, in the split doses, either 1-hourly or 4-hourly ones. Same thing, Anju, as I told you, Paris quarterly is also given in the same way. Split doses, 3 doses in a day with a 4-hour interval. No, they see, Shushankar, there is no this thing for in homeopathy. OAN for all the cases of osteoarthritis, no. Not all the cases of osteoarthritis may require the OAN. So many times your well-indicated remedy itself will take care. Majority of the time. But when it is not taking care, when you think, and then that time, OAN is also one of the beautiful medicine you can think of. So there is no specifics in homeopathy. This disease, this remedy, nothing. Or either it is an intercurrent or it's a no sold, all the remedies has to be selected on symptom similarity only. That is the first guideline for a homeopathy. Okay, individualization is a must. For a pancreatitis, CM was given. 1 minute. I'll just read it because I could not read. No, I told no. So she did not go for surgery because surgery was posted next day, 7th morning. In the 6th evening, the report, scan report came. The calculi was not there in the CPD. And the pancreatitis is reduced, this thing. Why she they will do it? It is abundant. Surgery was not done. Okay? As I told you, her brother himself is a surgeon. So what the words he uses is, if all homeopaths started giving the treatment like this, the surgeon doesn't have any work. We have to go home. That's what the patient told. The patient was an MD from your college only. She finished her MD from the BHMS and MD, both from the your college. And during BHMS time, she was my student. That you have to ask the organizers. I don't know about PDF forum or the what the way they are giving. That organizer has to do that one. Okay. Huh. Potency selection, somebody asked the idea. See, as I told you in the beginning itself, selection of potency depends upon the intensity of the disease, the age of the patient, his susceptibility. His or her susceptibility and reactive power, the source of the medicine, either the disease is functional, structural, organic, pathology, all these gives the criteria for selection. For that, best book is read the posology from Stuart Close. You heard Stuart Close, Aditya? I think in third or final year, you have this subject, philosophy. Dr. Stuart Close, there is wonderful chapter called Posology. Please read. That is the best guidelines for selection of potency. Okay? What is high, what is low? It may vary from a person to person. For somebody, 200 is high. For somebody, 30 is also maybe a medium or high potency. For someone, it is CM is also the high potency. 10 may be medium potency. It varies. But at least it gives a broad guidelines how to select the potency, which potency should be selected. Again, your experience makes you the confident to use the right potencies in the right cases. Always I say telling the similimum doesn't mean only similar drug. It should be fit with the similar potency and similar dosage. Then only the true similimum will come. The true similimum is similar remedy with the right potency and right dosage is the similar. Okay. So thank you. Thank you very much. You can stop sharing. Sir, gap between intercurrent and constitutional, this thing, remedies. See, as I told you, only in acute intercurrents, if necessary, after the acute phase is over, recovery is fine, then you may give a dose of the constitutional medicine. But in the constitutional, the chronic, this one, it may not be required unless otherwise, again, when to repeat, will be given, guided by your patient only. If the symptoms started coming back, you give. Otherwise, not required. Okay? Any other questions? Hope I could answer your few other questions. If there is no further questions, I will ask the organizers some clarity on indication sulfur. See, as I told you, in this that case, which was already under the treatment of a senior homeopathic doctor, there it was the vital force was not quite strong enough to complete the case. It was an acute exacerbation of the chronic disease. Her vitality has to improve. That's why I given that sulfur with that potency. Their selection of potency depend on my time limit. See, when your remedy is right, at that time, you select a right potency, little higher potency, it can work better, faster. Otherwise, same sulfur, if I had given in a lower potency, it would have taken weeks, not days, weeks to give the same result. And there, it was a criteria was, I mean, time bound was very much. For that, you have to read the Dr. Vitolka's classical talks, the lecture on the classical prescription, something is there. You go to the first chapter where he tells, narrates about the one fever case where their student, both husband and wife as a student of the institute, they are staying there only in academy, that their child got high fever at that time. Dr. Vitolkas prescribes tuberculum CM. But being a mother, she was a little scared to give CM for such a small child. She gives in 10 m. And next day evening, the child was better. She goes back and asks, sir, what would have been happened if I had given the CM? Then what answer Dr. Vitolkas says, no? It would have just been the hours instead of days. Child would have been better in hours. That is the efficacy when you rightly selected right put. If you are very confident about your prescription and you want this very fast recovery, give and go for a higher potency. It gives the speedy results. Okay? Aditya, I think you got clarity. I don't know who asked this question about that for pancreatitis case. So hope I cleared their doubt.
Thank you, sir, for sharing your valuable experiences about the topic. I hope, like me, each and everyone who attended this session found it very informative and very enlightening. I also thank the technical team and student committee for their timely support. Before concluding the session, I'd like to inform that tomorrow on the 15th of May, we'll be having our 11th session, which will be on the topic, Cold to Cancer, A Day in Homeopathic Clinic, by Dr. Manohar MC. We wish to see your presence for the next session too. Thank you. Stay safe and have a good day.
Thank you very much
for your patient teaching, and personal thanks from our side. Once we requested you, without any hesitation, you agreed for the session. Being a alumnus of our college, we feel proud that you came up and took up this session. Thank you very much, and we also thank
Bharat. Always, even though I taught in a different colleges, whenever it is, I feel it is our college, means only one college comes is GHMC. I am also very proud to be a GHMCian. And for your information, I think it was missing in your introduction also. I taught in your college also. Not only I was a student, I taught for a few years when Dr. A.L. Patil was the principal. I taught for a few years in the college as a guest faculty.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah. Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Also, we thank Dr. Trupti Pai for assisting you along with the slide presentation. We thank you, Dr. Trupti. Also, I would like to put a point here. I was just going through the participants list. I saw one name coming up there, Professor Dr. B.D. Patil, sir. Our former principal of GHMC. I saw he was there for his full session. Just now he left before I thank him. I asked Swami sir to convey our thanks to him, sir.
Okay, sir. Definitely, I will convey. He is my teacher. He was my first principal of this college when I was a student. So he has such a humbleness. He could come and listen for his own student this lecture. It's the greatness of a good teacher. The good teacher is always a student. So I feel that I learn in every session, either I speak or as a participant, I learn from that one. Thank you. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. And I thank all the participants, and we would request you to continue the same attendance in tomorrow's session also. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you all.